at 6808, Amaranth Court. You good? And thank you, Mayor and City Council members, for allowing me to speak. And I would also like to congratulate to the incoming councilwoman to the Frisco City Council. The pet store business is booming with pet products and services. Frisco has over a dozen pet stores, proving that selling pets is not necessary to run a thriving pet store. Even in the Petland chain, approximately 12 Petland stores in the U.S., in each of its Canadian stores already adhere to products and services model. The problem with puppies selling pet stores is the sourcing of puppies. If you stop the sourcing, you will stop the problems. If you continue to regulate or add regulations, you will continue the problem. The city's already spending a lot of resources, and the Yelp reviews and disgruntled customers are enough evidence that the immediate approach is not working. Store-level regulations, near constant monitoring, straining an already busy PD, and diverting resources from all other taxpayers. 11 cities in Texas have enacted a humane pet store ordinance, along with 3 others looking to pass shortly, and 2 of them are located in North Texas. Some have passed humane sourcing ordinances, and other cities have passed ordinances that simply say no retail sale of dogs and cats, which by far is the best. It's simple, it's clean, and it needs no enforcement. Humane sourcing ordinances include 3 entities for pet store exemptions. It's an animal control agency, a city or county animal shelter, or an animal rescue organization, which is a tax nonprofit organization founded for the purpose of providing humane sanctuary or shelter for abandoned and unwanted animals. A USDA licensed breeder is not a humane source. Despite the fact that these breeders are licensed with the USDA, public records show that many stores, including Frisco Petland, have and continue, even in the last 2 years, to source most puppies from massive commercial breeders and brokers, many with egregious animal welfare records. The sourcing documents that you will receive show numerous examples of these practices and breeders. Frisco residents will still be able to obtain the pet of their choice from responsible breeders who sell directly to the public, or from the shelters, or from the rescues. I seriously hope that you will think about passing, at a minimum, a humane sourcing ordinance and prevent the ongoing negative impacts of these business practices on animals and families in the city and surrounding areas. Thank you.
Thank you. And I stand corrected. Martin Freely, in a form, he opposes.